Hey, good morning, everyone. I just stepped out of the house. I just got finished working out, doing some weight training. And I know I haven't made a video in over, I think it's been over a week. Not because I didn't miss you, because I have missed you guys. Lord has been teaching me some things over this last week, and I'm still learning. He's still revealing things to me, and I'm actually just like surprised by what he's been showing me. I've been at this plateau for about a little over a month, like right between 170 and 175. I fluctuate between the two variables. So, you know, I'll lose a few pounds and then gain it back. Lose a few pounds and then gain it back. And quite honestly, it had become a bondage for me, because I've had to, or at least in my mind, I've had to be so careful about my diet that it just became just too much. And I don't believe God wants us to live like that. He wants us to have freedom in our eating. So for me, if I wasn't eating all fruit and salads or some type of vegetables, whether they were cooked or raw, and I didn't stay away from salt and oil, I was gaining weight. I would lose weight if I was doing that. If I wasn't doing that, if I added a little bit of oil or a little bit of salt, then I was gaining weight. A ridiculous amount of weight. It was just kind of like, you know, this can't be. I'm doing everything right. What's up with this? So, you know, I just cried out to the Lord. I'm like, Lord, what is it that you want me to do? And he started revealing some things to me about him wanting me to be free in my eating. So, and I'm not going to go into detail right now about what he's had me doing, because I'm not done learning everything yet, and I'm not ready to kind of share that with everybody yet. But the bottom line is that he wanted me to listen to what he wanted me to do specifically every day. He wants me to be so in tune with him that in the whole scheme of things, it really won't matter what I eat. Because he just wants me to be obedient to him. And the whole reason that I'm on this journey in the first place is because I've had food addiction problems. I've had food addiction problems ever since I was a little kid. I mean, a really small kid. Like 5 or 6 years old. And I've used food for comfort. And God doesn't want us to use food for comfort. Well, he doesn't want me to use food for comfort. He wants me to come to him for my comfort. And, you know, food has had too high of a place in my life. Like, it has been like a little God. And God needs to be God in my life. For example, when I was eating all kinds of crazy foods, like fattening processed foods, the food was God. When I was eating fruits and vegetables and eating right, as I call it, the food was God. Because I was always concerned about what I was going to eat, when I was going to eat. If I went somewhere, would there be something for me to eat? And, you know, of course God wants me to eat foods that are as close to the way he made them as possible, but they cannot have the place in my life that I have put them. They just can't, because God wants to be in that place. I should not be thinking about food 24/7, about what I'm going to eat and what I'm going to drink. It shouldn't be that important. Now, don't get me wrong. I believe that that there's something good about the health message, about, you know, people eating fruits and vegetables. And even if you are a meat eater, you know, eating meat that is not processed by the dairy farmers the way that, you know, they process it today. If you're going to eat meat, try to eat it, you know, organically or grass-fed or however you want to look at it. And, you know, I'm not a vegan. I'm not a vegetarian. I'm whatever God tells me to eat. That's what I am. I'm not getting caught up in all the hype. That's what it is. It's hype. It's you know, veganism and vegetarianism and raw foodism and fruitarianism and it, whatever you say it. Fruitism, whatever. You guys know what I'm saying. It's a hype. Now, are people getting healed and healthy? And yes, I'm not speaking against those things. But what I'm saying is, it's really not that important in the whole scheme of things. God's word says, don't be worried about what you're going to eat and what you're going to drink and what you're going to wear and all those things. He said, don't worry about it. As a matter of fact, when he sent the disciples out to minister to 70, he said, eat whatever was put before you. Well, I don't think he would have said that if he wanted us just to be a vegetarian or just to be a vegan or just to be a raw foodist or just to be a meat eater or just to be a fruitarian. So, I want you to hear my heart. I'm not saying that the food companies and everybody involved in that stuff, they're not putting things in food and chemicals and all that stuff. I'm not even saying you're supposed to eat junk. I'm not even saying you can't be concerned about what the things you put in your mouth. But I'm saying is, what is the most important? Who is the most important? Is it the food and the food you eat? Or is it God? Which one is it going to be? Because both of those things can't have the same place. One is going to be above the other. Now, if I'm listening to what God tells me to eat, He probably is going to prefer me to eat the things that are most helpful for me. But I'm not also going to argue with God if I'm out to dinner at somebody's house and, you know, they offer, you know, some dish that I wouldn't ordinarily eat, and God tells me it's okay to eat it. I'm not going to not eat it. So, think on that. This whole journey is interesting. And let me tell you, ever since I got this revelation, I've been losing weight like crazy. I've been losing weight like crazy. So, it's not a fluke. God knows what's best for us. And it's not what we always think is best. He wants to be first place in our lives, not food and drink. So, anyway, I'll leave you with that. More to come. Bye.